Please be ready for a dictation of part 2 of an extract from Central Interim Budget. 5 seconds. Start. When natural calamities strike, farmers are generally unable to repay their crop loans. Presently, the crop loans are rescheduled for such affected farmers and they get benefit of interest subvention of 2% only for the first year of the rescheduled loan. Our government has now decided that all farmers affected by severe natural calamities where assistance is provided from National Disaster Relief Fund will be provided the benefit of interest subvention of 2% and prompt repayment incentive of 3% for the entire period of reschedulement of their loans. Besides agriculture, animal husbandry and fisheries sector also needs considerable support. I have increased the allocation for this sector to rupees 750 crore in the current financial year itself. I announce setting up of a separate commission to upscale sustainable genetic upgradation of cow resources and to enhance production and productivity of cows. The proposed commission will also look after effective implementation of laws and welfare schemes for cows. India is the second largest fish-producing nation in the world, accounting for 6.3% of global production, registering an average annual growth of more than 7% in recent years. The sector provides livelihood to about 1.45 crore people at the primary level. To provide sustained and focused attention towards development of this sector, our government has decided to create a separate Department of Fisheries. Madam Speaker, making India self-sufficient in food, exporting to the world to meet their food needs and producing food in the most organic way is one of our visions. High farm production and productivity will be achieved through modern agricultural practices and value addition. An integrated approach towards agro and food processing, preservation, packaging and maintenance of the cold chain will be our focus of attention. This government will work with state governments to allow farmers to benefit from National Agriculture Market, ENAM. The Agriculture Produce Marketing Committees Act would not hamper farmers from getting a fair price for their produce. Ease of doing business and ease of living both should apply to farmers too. We shall go back to basics on one count: zero budget farming. We need to replicate this innovative model through which in a few states farmers are already being trained in this practice. Steps such as this can help in doubling our farmers' income in time for our 75th year of independence. We have worked to bridge the urban-rural divide in the country. Honorable members in this August House, most of whom are from rural areas, will agree that several times in the past, only empty promises have been made to people living in our villages. During the last 5 years, we have undertaken targeted expenditure to improve their quality of life in all its dimensions. Our aim is to provide urban facilities in villages while keeping the soul of rural life intact. Madam Speaker, this is not merely an interim budget, but a medium of the country's development journey. All the transformation that we are witnessing is because of the passion of the people of our nation. The credit goes to them only. Development has become a mass movement during the period of our government. With this, I commend the budget to this August House. Stop.